हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एफएनबी क्लासेस एंड आई एम डॉक्टर हेमंत कुमार सिंह। वी आर इनटू द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ आवर सीरीज बेसिक रेस्टोरेंट टूल्स। इन द पार्ट फर्स्ट वी हैव कवर्ड द क्रॉकरी सेक्शन एंड इन दिस पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द स्टीलवेयर इंक्लूडिंग द फ्लैटवेयर, कटलरी एंड हॉलोवेयर। सो लेट्स बिगिन। Let us start the journey with some of the basic tools which are used in the restaurant and which are also a part of the stillware. First one is the water jug, and this is used to serve the water to the guests. We all know this, but then this is available in different shapes and sizes in the restaurant depending upon the class and style and the decor of the restaurant. Water jug. Another basic part of the stillware is the napkin holder. But we are going to use this napkin holder only in case if we are using the paper napkins. If we are serving the paper napkin to the guest in a restaurant, then only we are going to use this napkin holder. Otherwise, we do not. Because in fine dining restaurants and in good quality restaurants which are a part of the hotels, we only use the cloth napkins. But if in case we are using the paper napkins, then we can use this kind of napkin holder. Okay, another small but important piece of stillware which can be there in the restaurant is the menu card holder. But this we only use for the small menus or the short menus which are like the carte de jour, which are for a specific day only. And this is used, I'll show you how this is used, like this. We have the small menu and we can insert this menu in the menu card holder like this and we can place it on the table, right? The menu card holder. Now we have certain pieces of cutlery and flatware also with us. Like this is one of the largest forks which is used in the restaurant. But then this is only used in case we are having a garidon trolley or a carving trolley with us in the restaurant. This is a carving fork. And this is used in a pair along with the carving knife. So we have this carving fork as well as the carving knife. And this we use on the garidon trolley or the carving trolley to carve out a slice out of a big meat joint. And then we serve it to the guest. Carving fork. Now we have this service spoon and the service fork. So these are the part of the flatware. But then yes, we need to understand how do we categorize the flatware and the cutlery. Because in a layman language, all the forks, knives, spoons, they comes under the category cutlery. But then technically, cutlery only includes all the knives and other cutting equipments. All the knives and other cutting equipments. Whereas all the spoons and the forks are categorized under the head flatware. So this spoon and fork, these are a part of the flatware and not cutlery. So this is a service spoon and this is a service fork. We use this again in a combination which is known as a service gear. And in a fine dining restaurant or in good quality restaurants which are a part of the 5-star hotels, we always use this service gear to serve almost everything in the restaurant, right from the bread rolls, dinner rolls, or the bread, or the curry or gravy or rice or anything or any dish which is a part of the any of the cuisines. So this is the service gear, the service spoon and the service fork. Now the next I have the spoon, fork and the knife, and we use them for multi-purpose objectives. This is a AP spoon and a AP fork and an AP knife. The all-purpose spoon, the all-purpose fork and the all-purpose knife. So although we do have a lot of different spoons and knives and forks, but if the restaurant is not able to manage all those knife, forks and spoons, then they use these for everything. The all-purpose spoon, fork and knife. The next I have this spoon. Now this is a soup spoon and we have discussed in the last video also how to use the soup spoon along with the soup bowl. Soup spoon. Next we have this small but long spoon. This is known as the Sunday spoon and also as the parfait spoon. So, and this goes with the long drinks or with the sundaes, that sundaes are made up of the juices and ice creams and fresh fruit juices and purees. They are served in the tall glasses. For that we use this Sunday spoon or the parfait spoon. Okay friends, next is this spoon, and This is the spoon having maximum number of uses in any of the restaurant. This is the teaspoon, a very multi-purpose kind of spoon known as teaspoon. And then we have another small spoon, the coffee spoon. You can compare these two spoons, the teaspoon and the coffee spoon. Okay, the next piece of steelware we have is this. This is the plate cover. Although we do not use this plate cover in the restaurant most of the times, this we use in the room service. And the usage of this plate cover is to cover the plate if we are carrying something pre-plated. Just to cover the plate while carrying something pre-plated for room service. Next we have this platter. This is an oval platter, but this is metallic stainless steel platter with a matte finish. In the earlier video, we have seen the ceramic platters also, the oval ones and the rectangular ones, right? So the platter for the starters, snacks and salads also, a platter. This is a ice cream cup. Again, a piece of steelware, and we can have this of bone china also. So this is used to serve the ice creams, but not necessarily only ice creams. It is also used for serving various other desserts. And it includes the serving of various Indian desserts also, including the gulab jamuns and other things, right? But whenever we are using this ice cream cup, it should always have an underliner, and it is always served with a teaspoon. Now we have next is the finger bowl. This is the finger bowl with an underliner, and as we all know that we serve this after the main course. This contains some lukewarm water and a lemon wedge, just to remove the odor, just to wash our hands and to remove the odor from our hand or fingers, right? Finger bowl. This is something we serve mostly in the breakfast and sometimes in the lunch or dinner also, if we are serving some soups, right? So this is a butter dish. And this dish is having three different parts. As you can see, this is the lid part, top part, and then we have this base and then this strainer kind of thing, right? So in the base, we used to have the crushed ice or very chilled water. And then in this strainer thing, we place the butter cubes and then we keep the lid. And you can see there is a notch also. So you can place a butter spreader or a teaspoon like this. A butter spreader or some kind of tong or a spoon also. So this is a butter dish. Now this is very much visible and clear also. This is a reserve tag, and we keep this on the table whenever we are trying to preoccupy a table for a particular guest, so that no other guest sits there. So this is a reserve tag. Let's see these two steelware pieces. These are the entree dishes. In this we serve the main course, the gravies and the curries. But the sizes are different. These are the round entree dishes with lid. I can show you this way also. This is a one portion dish and this is a two portion dish. So an entree dish with a lid. Okay, so next is the tea set and the coffee set. This is a teapot for carrying the tea liquor or the black tea. This is a coffee pot for carrying the coffee liquor or the black coffee. And then we have this sugar pot, but technically we call this a sugar basin. There's one thing which is important here is that we can use both the grain sugar also and the sugar cubes also. But if you are using the grain sugar, then we should use a spoon with this. And if you are using the sugar cubes, then there should be a tong with this. That's more important, right? Next is this, the milk pot, which we call it in the layman language, but then technically this is known as the creamer. So we have this coffee set and this tea set. Again, this is very important not to mix these two pots. If this is for tea, this has to be for tea every time. We should not mix these two pots. Because you know, if there is a guest who wants to have coffee and he doesn't like tea, so he never wants to have a coffee with some flavor or the aroma of tea. So that's why we should keep these two pots separate, for tea, for coffee. Okay, I have some more pieces of steelware, but then most of the times we do not use these pieces of steelware in the restaurant. But then yes, they are a part of the back area, that is the pantry. So let's have a look. This is one of them, and this is known as a spaghetti rack. This is used to take out the spaghetti, or mainly the spaghetti, but then it can be used for taking out any other pasta from the boiling water or the warm water. Spaghetti rack. Next is we have a multi-purpose tong. Although we should not be using these tongs in the restaurant, in good quality restaurants, in fine dining or any of the restaurant which is a part of the good 5-star hotel. So we should always use this thing, which is the service gear and not the tong. But then yes, some of the restaurants, they use these tongs, multi-purpose tongs. This is again we use in the pantry area, because pantry area is responsible for, you know, creating the fruit juices or the salads. So whenever we are using apple for juices or for salad or for something else, we need to core the apple. So we need to remove the central part along with the seeds. So for that we use this thing, and this is known as the apple corer. We insert like this in the center of the apple and we take it out. So this, you know, this takes out the center core part along with the seeds. Apple corer. This is again a very important piece of tool, steelware, which is used in the pantry, because in the pantry we use a lot of tins. For example, the tins of the canned juices, tins of cheese, tins of mushrooms and a lot of other things. So to use or to open those tins, we use this tin cutter. We do have a manual tin cutter also, but then that tin cutter doesn't cut the top part of the tin very cleanly, and there may be chances of, you know, getting somebody hurt. So this removes that top part of the tin very nicely and cleanly. So this is a tin cutter. So I do have these two things, although these are not a part of the steelware, but then yes, a very important pieces of tools in the restaurant. These are the bread baskets, a round one and an oval one. And whenever we are serving the breads or the poppadoms or the breakfast rolls or the dinner rolls in these bread baskets, we should always use a cloth napkin beneath. Without the cloth napkin, we should not use them. Okay friends, so we have come to the end of the part 2 of the series, basic restaurant tools. And in this part, we have covered the steelware, including the flatware, cutlery and some of the hollowwares. So in the third and the last part of this series, we will be covering the glasswares. So stay tuned for that episode. If you like the content and the information, please do like and subscribe the channel, and also hit the bell icon for the future notification of my videos. Thank you for watching.